Hello, everybody. My name is Invictad. Welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance. Today, we're going to be taking a look at Tainted Samson, your first look here on the channel. Now, this is the second run that I'm playing as Tainted Samson. The first one didn't go so well because we had like 10, 20, 30,000 Tinted Rocks that didn't give us a Soul Heart. So we're going to see what happens when we go for Angel Deals this time, because Devil Deals really aren't worth it in Repentance anymore. That's right. I said it. So thank you all very much for the continued support on the Repentance series. It's been absolutely record-setting in the Mosh Pit, and the channel has been exploding. So welcome all new members here on the YouTube Mosh Pit as well. And don't forget that this Saturday will be my first ever annual birthday stream on YouTube. So make sure you don't miss that. I don't know what time it's going to start, probably sometime in the early afternoon. Just make sure you turn on notifications and you will get notified. So here we go. Going to go for, I don't know, let's go for something on Tainted Samson. Surely. We got to do something. Alpha Hotel 4 Lima, November Charlie 3-4. So what is the Undying Rage and what is the Berserk ability for Tainted Samson? Essentially, after a little while, you're going to see, after either dealing damage or taking damage, Samson will start turning red and get progressively redder and redder until he gets to a boiling point, which then he turns into a Berserk form of himself, which does have like a very high damage melee swing. On top of that, he has increased movement speed. And he also has a ranged attack, which he can throw, much like the Forgotten's bone attack. And it's very, very cool. Samson looks metal as all get out whenever he transforms. And there you go right there. So that is Samson's, this is Samson's undying, berserking rage form thing. And every time you get a kill, it will reset the cooldown of it. So notice how right now we're still in the berserking, the berserking mode, because we've been constantly killing over and over again. You'll hear a little like countdown timer kind of ding whenever the timer is about to go off. Yeah, so right there. So we were able to kill pretty much almost the entire floor there before the undying berserking rage, whatever you want to call it, berserk form, stopped. It's a little cheeky damage there with the orbital, and yeah, there we go. We get Roid Rage here, which is going to give us movement speed and range. Going to go back and grab a whole bunch of stuff that we missed with this bomb here. So, but yeah, I'm a big fan of Tainted Samson in the only run that I've ever actually played him on. It was a lot of fun. We had a golden opportunity to go very, very far, especially with Mega. But like I said, going after Devil Deals was a little bit too ham. And I made the decision, like, Devil Deals just really are not that worth it. Just going to say it. They're not worth it. Angel Deals are going to be the way to go, and that's exactly what we're going to be doing here. Yeah, we go back and grab that red heart here if I feel like we need it. So, again, the Berserking Rage, it triggers off of taking damage and dealing damage. I don't really care about one red heart. We'll be fine. We'll be fine. We could get the membership card, and the membership card is going to open up a new section of the floor, a new section of floor to the store, which will allow us to have an increased amount of better items to buy. Now, the problem is that we don't have any money, so I don't think the membership card is that worth it. I personally feel like if I could change one thing about the membership card, it would be it automatically gives you 50% discount, because it already is costing 15 cents. And then the cost of the items down below are very, very expensive. So I think that an automatic Steam sale, although it wouldn't stack with the Steam sale, would be pretty darn awesome. And we could play this down to zero red hearts, but I'm going to just go ahead and I'll just ignore it. Head on down. First, the maze. Okay. All right, get some kills there with our Forever Lone Fly. So there's the, this is the melee. You can see the melee form here with Samson. Now, one thing that's nice and cool about the Berserk form is that you can actually reflect shots back with the melee weapon that Samson uses. And another thing that's really cool is that, it, much like the Forgotten, you can actually use the melee weapon to swing at things that are out of range and pick them up. So, like, for example, if a card was locked behind a bunch of rocks, you potentially, assuming that you're in the berserking mode, you could reach over and just grab it. And that's pretty awesome. The half-price soul heart here. Okay, we get our 7 cents. So before we use this, before we buy that soul heart, let's see what's down in the membership club. A half price soul is pretty awesome. I think we got to take the half price soul. And then we can also pick that up as well. So that was a really, really good shop there. Samson going berserk. We get Rotten Baby, which is going to cost us a soul heart. I don't know why we bounced off of the spikes like that, but so Rotten Baby is going to give us a little bit of range support here, especially whenever we go into the berserking mode. We should be able to deal mucho damage with that. Gonna be Dingle. Yeah, that is a lot of damage right there. Get the screw, which is gonna give us a little bit shot speed and tears rate. Not gonna go into the item room just because, and I think we just gonna head on down. Item room, I mean Devil Deal. My God. In terms of unlocks, I'm not in, I mean, it just, the default answer is going to be whatever, like however our run is turning out. Like right now, when there's nothing super special about this run, so I wouldn't expect anything major to be unlocked here. But you never know. We'll get a store key. Two bombs. Even if we get in there, we can't heal for soul hearts, and we don't have enough bombs to get into the crawl space, so I don't see a point of going into a bedroom for now. Look, it's a pestilence, not gonna help us out that much. A little dodging there. Yeah, might as well. The guppies. Yeah, makes sense, game. You gotta love that the bombs that spawned earlier lasted the longest. Gotta love it. Alright, let's not start throwing away a bunch of HP here. Get Guppy's head, which is gonna again help us whenever we go into berserk mode. Don't get more bombs, or we don't get more keys. So we could skip some item rooms to go for planetariums, but again, I think that I just want to go for regular just unlocks right now. Maybe where we're sitting at by the time we get to Mom, let's see if we can go to Lamb and Satan, because that is going to give us a kill. Or that should at least give us an unlock anyway. Yeah, we have no keys. Yeah, no Yabes. Might as well go into the boss fight real quick. So Gertie spawns adds. So we should be able to keep up berserking pretty much nonstop. Nope, never mind, just kidding. There goes Gertie Sr. No angel deal. We get consolation prize, which is going to give us some damage. Would have loved to have gotten an angel deal there. We do get a Yave. Walked out to walk and walk back in so we wouldn't lose our flies there. HP up is honestly a-okay by me. We need 3 cents. Oh, I take that back. We need two more cents. Never mind. Okay. 120 volts can be pretty darn awesome for us whenever we've got Berserking going. See, if we get Berserking, we can go back there and pick up that... you can pick up that Locus of Pestilence. The 120 volt is going to zap anything that gets close enough to us without realizing it, and it's going to deal a whole lot of damage to him in very rapid succession. But it's a pretty short range on the ability. Hopefully we'll just get... We just need 2 cents, game. Thank you. Okay, we could go in the curse room. I'm going to choose not to. We could go in the bedroom. I'm going to choose not to. Again, for the aforementioned reason, I don't think there's anything necessary that we need in there. And we don't have enough bombs anyway to really make it worthwhile. So I'm happy with just getting an HP upgrade. And we can also stop and get the soul heart as well. And you live and you die by the HP upgrades in Repentance. And, you know, as silly as it may seem to put that much emphasis on just a regular HP upgrade, that's just a sign of the time, man. You got to have the HP if you want to win. And curse the blind. So, assuming that we get an angel deal here, we're not going to know what it is. Hilarious, Edmund. We could use some more HP here. I wouldn't mind getting some shoop. Or just one key is fine too, I guess. Yeah, I was able to snag that penny before the Berserking wore off. Big time get right there, let me tell you what. Heard a little bit of the 120 zap right there. Baby, I'm gonna need you to step it up a little bit. You're our ace in the hole here. There we go. Golden key, okay. Take unlimited keys. I'll also take a free bomb here. So that's the only downside to this floor here is just the fact that we've got Curse of the Blind and we have absolutely no clue what we're going to be getting out of our angel deal or what we miss. Now, that being said, for the item room, we can leave the item room if we think that we're going to come back here and do Dogma. And right now, I don't see that happening. Get Bloody Lust. It's pretty darn good. A Bone Heart as well, which is also pretty darn good if we can actually fill it. So let's see what this playing card is here because it could be something good. Not. And we're going to go all the way back because this Boneheart's really, really important. Okay. The Boneheart here protecting our soul hearts is going to give us a little bit more of a forgiveness factor. We could even go into the curse room if we really wanted to. I think what we should do first is fight the boss. And also, it is Curse of Blind, so curse rooms. No Magusta on that. Little pin threw himself into the fire. No, never again. I mean, I'd rather have the increased tinted or the increased soul heart drop chance. Oh, wow, really? Okay. There we go. Perfect. No angel deals, 73% chance, and dad's lost coin. All right. Burn, 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 burn. How about that angel deal chance? Only took us 5 floors to get an angel deal. Pretty happy about that. Lover's card. Of course, Bloody Lust is going to allow us to deal more damage based on how much damage we've taken for the entire level, which is what regular Samson starts with. Definitely want a treasure map, because your boy always needs it. We didn't get a, did not get a nickel from the Penny-Eyed Keeper. And that could be a Yair rune, but probably isn't. We need 5 cents for the treasure map. All right, 4 cents for the treasure map. You have the 120 volt going off, doing lots of big time damage. Job rotten, baby. The soul heart, 2 cents to pay dirt. That would be a patented Invicta full clear right there. Oh, okay. That hit us, huh? Definitely feel like the hitboxes on those spike rocks are a little, need a little calibration. Just a little bit. Upgrade there. Piggy bank sometimes gives you money, sometimes doesn't. If we can get the IV bag or if we can get an arcade, that would be pretty incredible. So we are definitely going to be able to get the treasure map for show. Right now, I'm just checking to see if we can find said arcade, but we didn't. Depths 1. I think we might as well go fight the boss real quick. Yeah, I got a little bit of extra cheeky damage there with the Berserk mode. Now goes Sisters. No problem. All right, range upgrade, and let's see what's in our angel deal. Oh boy, Eucharist. All right, Neato. Might as well fight the angel statue. Icarus is going to give us a 100% deal with the angel chance, which is what we want. Problem is that my only complaint about that is the fact that like it showed up on floor 5. We've been going for angel deals since like floor 2 or floor 3 technically. So missing the 73% was the turning point for me in my hope. We have a golden bomb though. Gold bomb's going to allow us to basically, maybe we could check for crawl spaces and that sort of thing. Another bone heart over here. I will take it. You gotta give those spikes a wide berth. I mean, a wide berth. Now, in the first Samson run, we did complete boss rush. It is a Yara rune. Well, I'll be god dang. Well, I'll be a son of a gun. A 6-cent Yara rune. Oh, not this. Not the right way. Watch out for the spike rock! Here's hoping that we get a good angel deal out of this one. So hard, okay. Nice. Cool. Immaculate Conception. Neato. Here's up. We'll take. Not many bombs, unfortunately. Probably should have thought about Yaring that. I am going to go inside of the curse room here because we've got the golden heart. Not sure why we didn't take any damage coming out of the curse room though. That was kind of odd. I'm not going to complain, of course, but that was a little bit weird. Volt doing some pretty good work. Oh man. Super magnet, no thank you. Welcome to the meat grinder. It's Parkway Drive said, they said it best. Just bodies through the teeth of the combine. That is the essence of Tainted Samson. Okay. All right. Here we go. Okay. All right. Okay. So let's go to our item room here. Definitely could use some more damage. I wouldn't mind it. This is not where our item room is, unfortunately. Here's where our item room is. And Samson just goes absolutely ballistic. I love it. The Mon transformation, which is pretty good. Small rock. Yeah, we'll take it. We did ask for more damage, and boy, howdy, did we get it. Now, with this run here, I'm not feeling as confident as I was with the last run that we did on Tainted Samson just because we had Mega for that one. But I don't know if I want to go. I don't know if we want to go up or if we want to go down. Again, we've already done boss rush, so I'm not worried about doing boss rush again on Tainted Samson. Now, Tainted Samson is very good against Mom because of all the adds, especially Blue Mom. Theoretically, anyway. Trying to get in there and get some cheeky 120 volt damage. I do want... Let's go up. Love that we can just yeet the angel's shots right back at him. It's so good. We will head on Dizown. Okay, so it looks like the boss is going to be to the bottom left. Or bottom right, rather. Also known as southeast. Wouldn't mind getting a red heart here. If we can save this bone heart, that would be ideal. I do like the reckless abandoned playstyle of Tainted Samson a lot. Where you kind of have limited time to capitalize on him going just nuts. I really dig that. Again, it's nice to have another melee focused character. Maybe not melee focused, but a melee enhanced character in the game, like Gotten. Careful. Another golden heart, another HP upgrade. Get the rosary. Yeah. All right. Well, I was really hoping that we were going to go through this run and get, like, you know, some kind of pretty amazing angel deal item. But, you know, getting... I mean, we are getting a bunch of HP, so I guess... When we want HP, don't worry. It's going to flow like the river of the buffalo. I don't know. So you hear us resetting the timer in there. Little pins, please. You thought I was going to get hit there, didn't you? You thought I was going to take damage in that room. Doing a pretty good job at damage avoidance on this run, I got to say. Only taking minimal amounts of damage. The soul said, nope. Lost that bone heart, unfortunately. Get Holy Grail. All right. All right. Well, we might as well go fight old Hushy then, I guess. Old Hushy. All right, old Hushy, what you got? Black hole, huh? Jacob's ladder. Now you're talking my language, old Hushy. Hey, to win. Would have been nice a while ago. Could be a Perthro rune. Probably won't take it. Definitely need some Yaves here. What is that? The Zippo? What does the Zippo do? Let's see. All a lighter. Chance for enemies to burn when entering a room. Ah. Not very good. We get the Bible. Oh, they gave us Seraphim anyway, so there's that. Alright, here we go. Old Hushy. Jacob's Ladder going to be big help to us. Not quite sure how the melee is going to be. Oh, okay. Didn't think that was going to hit us. So for these instances here, I don't think that going in with melee is the smartest move. So we're going to have to wait. We're going to have to wait out the berserkness. Now remember, every time we take damage, we do have Bloody Lust as well, so. All right, we are 5% through. Yeet, 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 yeet. We got some pretty decent damage there. Again, trying to get close enough to where we can deal damage with a 120 volt. Berserk really tore up Hush there. Hush, gonna need you to calm down, sir. Don't like how fast the new beams move. They outpace Isaac by default. And Hush is just going to keep on doing it, huh? All right, that was... We got the Soul of Samson! Hey! That was rougher than it should have been. Put some money back in the old donation machine here. What else was down here? Eternal Heart, definitely will take that. Might as well see if this is... It is a Perth Row. Okay, all right now. PH Dizzle. Don't worry, we'll put that back. PH Dizzle, what we got? Perks. Perks is pretty good. Perks is going to save us through Mega Stanley. I mean... I actually think that we're going to go with Perks here. If we're going to try to get Mega Stan down, then we're going to need the Perks bill. Especially since we have zero keys right now. So, yeah. I think we'll just take Perks and we'll head on up. Looks like Isaac's going to be to the southwest, I would guess. Yeah, 120 volt getting some massive damage in there. That's what I like to see, son. What I like to see, Sam, son. Sam, son. Oh, God. Holy bonies, we don't want any. We don't want any. Whatever you're selling, you can keep. And we went the wrong way. Right. We'll get 5 bombs for our troubles, I suppose, and a soul heart to boot. Okay. Just had a hunch. Must have been gas. Oh, what? They picked up the pot so it could shoot us. What is that, Ed? What's this? Soul of Samson. We just unlocked that. Isaac gains berserk for 10 seconds. So it basically is an on-use berserk, basically. Good damage there. All right, well. A little bit of extra damage there. Oh, I love it. You love to see it. You love to see that. Wow. Soul of Samson's real good. All right. So we still have to go to Blue Baby. And then we turn around. We got to go fight Megastan. Have exactly four keys. Ogish, Mystery Egg, Papa Fly, and Toxic Shock. Hooray. Blue Baby's gonna be on the far east side of the map. Pretty silently and quietly, we've gotten a almost max tier delay, which I didn't really even notice until just now. A tier delay is really, really good. Wouldn't mind less than three here for another HP upgrade. Every HP we get basically is going to be doubled. Or we could just get none. That's fine too. We'll use the Black Rune on our Chesterinos over here. Hey, we got damage and we also got tears and more shot speed too. Oh my goodness. You know, big time damage there. For a little Gistra proc on him. Well, you don't want to square up with this war, I promise you. You got big time damage there. Got a rotten fly as well as a golden key. Let's go. Priestess. High Priestess could help us against Blue Baby, I suppose. We want to get a little more HP. The damage there by 120 volt. Tooth and Nail is going to give us some little bit of a vulnerability every now and then. You'll hear a little pop. Yeah, we get a Yara rune as well, which, I mean, we could use the Yara rune on the perks pill and use it against Blue Baby just in case, so to mitigate some damage here. I think I'm going to do that. Okay. So perks is going to give us the wafer effect for one room, which is going to have all of our damage, all the damage that we take. This is just a measure here. In case if we get hit, we don't want to lose a full heart. There you go. Really good damage there with Samson. Going in berserk mode, hitting all the shots back at him. I don't think the reflected shots do anything, but happy to have that. All right. So that was Blue Baby. We got that one down. And we're going to have a full amount of HP here. Well, a full amount for what we have. 7 full hearts ready to go for Mega Stan. This is going to be a big one. We can get this down, I'll be happy. Here we go. Knocking out Hushy and Mega Stan would be pretty awesome. Look at the damage there from 120 volt. Oh my goodness. Jacob's Ladder helping us out too. Very happy that we at least have flying for this fight. Not the cleanest of phases, I'll admit. But we don't have great movement speed. I think we skipped Stanley there. Or he's doing this phase for some reason. Excuse me, Stan, you can't do that. It's illegal. All right, so we got through there with 2 hits. Not too bad. Soul putting in some major work here. Big time play, Soul. Got him. There we go. Mega Stan down. We get the crane game, whatever that is. And hey, look at that. We got some marks on Samson. Tainted Samson, that is. So thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click the like button. Also, leave a comment down below. Let me know what some of your favorite synergies are with Tainted Samson. I think he's a lot of fun. He's metal. He's mad. He's just like me. And it's a good time playing him. So again, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you click the like button. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. As always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.